Good afternoon, Kapamilya. Here are some of the biggest stories from BA News.
While most New Yorkers try to enjoy the tail end of the summer season, a handful of United States Democratic lawmakers cut their break short and headed back to Washington, D.C., hoping to make headway on a gun safety bill. All this in response to back-to-back mass shootings in El Paso, Texas, and in Dayton, Ohio, less than 2 weeks ago, that left at least 31 people dead and dozens injured. A handful of senators met with White House officials Wednesday to talk about gun legislation. But 44 states still have a provision in their state constitutions which protects the citizens' right to keep and bear arms. Some Filipino Americans we have spoken to in Texas believe that the El Paso shooter could have been stopped sooner if other people had their firearms. PhilAm activists are expressing outrage upon learning that a transgender Filipina was not only denied entry into a woman's bathroom in the Philippines, Gretchen Custodio Diaz was also reportedly slapped, dragged, arrested, and detained by mall security. In New York City, transgender rights activist Gina Rosero and other LGBTQ+ advocates weighed in.
It's really a simple fact. We saw in the video how she was really treated badly and horribly and like a subhuman. Like, this is a human being. She just wanted to go pee.
There is supposed to be an ordinance that protects LGBT people and trans women. But the sad thing is it seems to be just in paper. And it's not, you know, it's not practice, not put into practice.
On a Facebook post, Diaz said that she's looking at legal options she can take and will send another update once a case has been filed by her legal team.
That night we ride through the mansions of glory and suicide machines.
How did music make a difference in a young immigrant's life? Blinded by the Light answers this question and tells a story of a person's courage to pursue one's dreams, talks about immigrant lives, and the universal power of the music of Bruce Springsteen. Springsteen's music pervades this critically acclaimed movie about a British teenager of Pakistani descent while he was coming of age in a small town in England in the late 80s. The film is inspired by the book of Sarfraz Manzoor, whose love of Springsteen's music enabled him to escape the harsh realities of his early life, which included poverty and racist attacks. The film is directed by Bend It Like Beckham filmmaker Gurinder Chadha.
And that wraps up BA News Breaks for today. I'm Ginger Conejero. See you next time.